perceptions towards teacher-student interpersonal relationship. So the relationship between the teacher and the students is sensitive, especially because the stereotypes dictate the authority of the teacher and the submissiveness of the learners. So this letter, this relation, gives all the rights to the teachers and marginalizes the learners. However, the shift from a teacher-learner, a teacher-centered classroom, to a learner-centered classroom engendered changes of different kinds. So this shift revolutionized every aspect in the classroom, including teacher-students relationship. So the teachers shifted, the teachers shifted from a totalitarian or authoritarian to a guide, a mentor, a facilitator, and the learners shifted from passive recipients of knowledge to active participants. So this is a picture that shows the teacher-student relationship before and today. So in 1961, for example, it was the teacher and the parents who scream on the student because of his low marks. And in 2011, with modernization, with globalization, it is the student and his or her parents who scream on the teacher. So this research investigates the climate of today's classroom in order to highlight the viewpoints of the students about this relationship at the University of Béjaïa. So it asks the question, what is today's relationship between the two main agents of the classroom and what is its impact on students' learning? So as the school serves as an agent of social exchange, it embodies values, social knowledge, such as social relations, social differences, social rights, etc., and manifests behavior, tolerance, open-mindedness, and sense of community. Therefore, education includes social learning, and the teacher is the main mediator for achieving such purpose. As a quotation, Ravitch writes, "The goal of education is not to produce higher test scores, but to educate children to become responsible people with well-developed minds and good character." So this relationship between teacher and student influences students' civic knowledge, civic attitudes, and future participation in the society. In other words, teachers' practices and attitudes in the class dictate in a significant way, of course, among other ways, students' attitudes and future expectations. So the relationship provides a unique entry point for educators and others working to improve the social and learning environments of schools and classmates. So the study relies on a number of students' diaries. So I have asked the students to write diaries responding to two questions. What is the current relationship between you and your teacher? And what is the expected or the wished relationship? That is the relationship you want to have with your teachers. So the results gave two answers. For the existing teacher-students relationship, we have two points of view. So the students said that few teachers are supportive, helpful, enthusiastic, passionate, and all the students affirmed that the respect exists. So a respectful relationship exists between them and their teacher. The picture shows an example of a supportive teaching. So the teacher helps her learner in the activity. The second category, or the other point, The teachers are distant. So the students, they said that the majority of the teachers are distant from their learners. Most of the students claimed that a limited teacher-student relationship to providing knowledge. So the teachers are here just to provide knowledge. This is the feeling of the students. There is no personal relationship between teacher-students. They feel the teachers far from them. Hardline and narrow-minded teachers, there is a relationship of work, dominant teachers, source performer of knowledge, and this is an example of an authoritarian teacher. Of course, this is just to make it funny. Okay. One of the respondents made a chart explaining the teacher and learner relationship. So for him or for her, the teacher is the speaker and the learner is the listener. The teacher is the information or provider, information provider or source, and the learner is the receiver. The teacher is the guide, the advisor, and the learner is just a learner. So the relationship is a one-way relationship from teacher to learner. So the respondents claim that such kind of relationship is not beneficial for both their effect and their learning. Their effect because they believe that a good relationship would help them shape their role, first as learners and second as future teachers and citizens. And besides, they believe that this hinders their learning because with such relation they lose motivation and self-esteem. These are some examples from students' responses. Now, this relationship doesn't help me to learn. I can't express freely my ideas. I feel that if I do a mistake, it means the teacher, will blame me because of the authority of the teacher. Actually, this relation doesn't really help me in that I sometimes don't feel at ease. I feel blocked during the course. For the second part of the research, the desired or the wished teacher relationship, all the students from all levels claim a close relationship with their teachers. A close relationship means a friendly relationship, a relationship that provides self-confidence and reassurance, that provides an enjoyable and motivating learning environment, a cooperative relationship, and the teacher should be a behavior model. The students want to feel comfortable, want to have a safe environment, a teacher who helps in need, a listener and sympathetic, and there should be a sincere complicity between the teacher and them, and the teacher who understands their needs. Accordingly, not only the new educational system and the shift of focus in the classroom entail such relationship, but also the students themselves. That is to say, they are aware of the suitable conditions of better learning and achievement among which a close teacher-students relationship. An example of the students' responses, the teacher should be as a confident shoulder to learn on to lean on, sorry, in case of sorrowful moments. The role of the teacher should never be limited to knowledge providing. It needs more than that to be a teacher, literally. We can't survive without one another, since there would be no teacher without any student. The teacher should be in the best picture with his students. A more friendly relationship is needed and wished. And the teacher is the key of the classroom. He should be a father, a mother, even a friend, a person who strives to understand our problems and works to solve them with available resources. The impact, so the positive and negative behaviors exhibited by the teachers have to a great extent an impact on students' achievement. So a good relationship fosters students' engagement, embeds good citizenship. In other words, the teacher-student relationship results from and impacts on both the teacher and learners as members of the society. It fosters students to participate in the community life and acquire social values and norms. And language teachers then can help their students master English and simultaneously become more knowledgeable citizens of the world through the exploration of topics related to civic education. Whereas a negative relationship is counterproductive and lowers students' attainment levels. Moreover, it influences the behavior of the learners as members of the society. Thus, if the relationship is not positive, this may actually weaken the love of learning and the desire to acquire knowledge. Therefore, it leads to the decrease of the learning process. Moreover, it disconnects students from the right way, that is, right behavior, right attitudes, and future expectations and practices of the learners as future citizens. So as a conclusion, adhering to moral principles is essential in every profession. Therefore, every profession has a deontology on its own. Teachers' deontology points to the rights and duties that have to be met. Among teachers' moral duties, the achievement of interpersonal relationships with the learners. Thank you for your attention.